get. And it's the second leading cause of death or disability. That's the kind of a problem that we can have. And it's the most common cause of disability all over the world. Every region of the world, every region of the country or the world can have this problem. And, you know, a person in the 40s or 50s can get a stroke. Youngs can become disabled. Not only disabled, but, you know, they may not be able to talk, they may not be able to work. They lose their livelihood. The whole family, which is dependent on a person working, the family just collapses because of this disability. And that's the problem, and that's why we need to look at this in a very big way. And you can see here that, you know, the next statistics is very striking. You know, among the 15 million strokes, nearly 6 million of them will not survive. And that's a huge, you know, burden. That's very important. And remember the next statistic, which is important. A new stroke occurs every 5 seconds. As I'm completing the sentence, somebody would have had a stroke. And that's a very, very striking thing. And the other important point, you see that it is, you know, 1 in 5 happens in females and 1 resident from 1 hospital. And you can see here that a given month, you'll have about 2,000 to 3,000 stroke patients. 2,000 stroke patients for a... Remember that, you know, even if they come on time, you see the number of patients who are getting appropriately treated. If you come very early, you have a group of people. But the press has got such a massive reach, outreach, and that is the reason why, you know, when you tell your 20% into 40% into 60%, then only we can call ourselves successful. Otherwise, it becomes a problem. Now, the other important point that what the press, you know, the risk factors for stroke, the risk factors, see that blood pressure, high blood pressure is the first, that's the important point. Heart disease, that's the third important cause of stroke. You know, if you have a bad heart, you're definitely likely to get, and stroke are interlinked. Old age itself is a risk factor for stroke. That we cannot modify. All of us become older, and the chances of getting a stroke is higher as we grow older. So that is what is called an unmodifiable risk factor. We cannot, you know, at least 150 minutes of walking a week, 150 minutes of walking, brisk walking, that means about 20, you know, sub-classification stroke. One is, when the blood pressure becomes very high, the blood vessel can break and produces what is called a hemorrhage. That's inside the brain. So it destroys the brain by means of brain hemorrhage. It's a very catastrophic one symptom, chest pain. Majorly, heart attack, everybody knows. Even the commonest, you know, what is called FAST. FAST means face. That means face. F is feeling properly. That could
be breathing, alertness. For all basic functions, you need a brainstorm. So that is blocked and he had recurrent symptoms. He was unconscious, all 4 limbs were paralyzed. So we decided that, yeah, you need to have an intervention. So with the help of our interventionist, we performed the rarest, the first of the whole country, which was not been, trial in many centers. So we took the risk and hopefully the family members understand the risk for that. He slowly recovered and now he is standing. He can talk, he can share his views. Good evening, sir.
Nada, okay. Angila Tapasa, the other, Tabula Pasa, and a poor Tapas, and all Tapas, but not long,
Dr. Satish Kumar sir, Komali was in very critical conditions. We were about to lose 95% in our family over the years. And we were directly explained the surgery, in the situation, in the complications, how could we make it happen? That we explained it. And we were okay with it. We play with that. And we are Mr. Dr. Vinesh and Dr. Nigel Burris. And here there is hardly 45 minutes. The surgery was just 45 minutes. Less than a very quick, and we are much happy with the rehabilitation and the kind of
movements.
Yeah, the movements, rehabilitation. From the emotionally, he was like so disturbed after his stroke. He helped us like recover from this emotional thing, everything. And I really should appreciate the entire team to bring him to this level, because you would have definitely lost him, like literally lost. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks.